Now in our exploration of God's promises, we skip ahead to the 1800s.
It was another time where many were crying out for deliverance and care.
So many were lost and hoping for someone to come and find them.
God saw their need and sent deliverers to find them, pull them up, and show them the right way.
William and Catherine Booth.
1865.
England.
What a time.
What a place.
And what a couple.
It all started in England.
In the dismal slums of poverty.
There were more than 3 million people who were homeless, just in England alone.
The Booths saw this with great sadness because they knew these people needed help.
And so, they acted.
Here is the darkest of England, but where is God's church?
These are the suffering. Why hasn't anyone seen them?
We have seen, so we will act. God will have all of us from this moment forward.
Yes, and with God, we will find a way to them. And once we've reached them, we'll find a way out of the darkness for those who are ready to receive Christ.
Yes, I can see it now, the way out of this darkness. They will all be found and helped.
The Booths, after seeing what they called the darkest of England, sought to find the way for those in suffering, and they started a movement that helped people in this life and prepared their hearts for the next.
William Booth was often caught asking, what is the point of only preaching the gospel to men whose whole attention is concentrated upon a mad, desperate struggle to keep themselves alive?
And so they started the Christian Mission, which later became the Salvation Army. And they would regularly be heard preaching soup, soap, and salvation. And through their mission, they sought to save the body and soul for both time and eternity.
The Salvation Army was often found on the street preaching or in the taverns seeking out the truly lost.
And they were met with some opposition. Many people didn't like these new tactics of Salvation Army soldiers, like shiny and big brass bands playing the familiar pub tunes with different words, and they felt disrupted.
Lots of the people in opposition would throw things at them in hopes to get them to stop or go away.
But the Booths took it all in stride and sent more bands to proclaim the message of Christ on the streets of England. They met every person in opportunity with great strength and always continued to seek and find those who were lost.
If we are to better the future, we must disturb the presence and continue to seek out those in the dark. We must fight for them.
Yes, we will always fight. Just look at them. They're crying out and they may not even know it. While women weep, as they do now, I'll fight.
And while children go hungry, as they do now, I'll fight.
While men go to prison, in and out, as they do now, I'll fight.
While there is a poor lost girl upon the streets,
while there remains one dark soul without the light of God,
we'll fight. We'll fight till the very end.
The Salvation Army launched an offensive throughout the British Isles that, in spite of violence and persecution, converted 250,000 Christians between 1881 and 1885.
Their message spread rapidly, gaining a foothold in America and soon after, Canada, Australia, France, Switzerland, India, South Africa, Iceland, and Germany.
Today, the Salvation Army is active in virtually every corner of the world and serves in over 100 countries, offering the message of God's healing and hope to all those in need.
God sent the Booths out, and they told the truth of God to each person they met. Through their calling, the world was changed.
We yet have reached our glory, but I will gladly join the fight. Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? like you could fall and no one would hear.